Back at the wall. Today I'm talking Curaçao, the lovely sweet orange liqueur that pops up in so many classic cocktails. What you might not know is that Curaçao originates from a particular place. Any guesses what it's called? Yes, Curaçao comes from Curaçao, a small island 40 miles north of Venezuela. You may be familiar with it from this bottle. Well, Bols is a Dutch brand, and guess who took Curaçao from the Spanish in 1634? The Spanish having taken it from the Arawak in 1499. Yeah, when I started looking into it, the history of Curaçao is pretty depressing. So how is it different from other orange liqueurs? Curaçao is made from lajara, an inedible bitter orange native to the island, which is a descendant of the Seville orange. Its exact origins are disputed, but two companies claim to have invented it. Our friend Bols and this guy, which Audrey got for me in Curaçao, but is also available in the States. This is actually a very cool product. It's one of the few made entirely from lajara, and the company is based in Curaçao. It's also made by hand in the family's 100-year-old copper still. Let's try it. Smells really orangey. Just pops with orange flavor. This is a lot sweeter than other orange liqueurs you've had, but it tastes great. If you're wondering if this can be plugged into any recipe that calls for orange liqueur, the answer is maybe. If a recipe calls for Cointreau or Grand Marnier, my recommendation is to use those if you have them. There are slight variations in all these products' flavor profiles, and in my opinion, they shouldn't be used interchangeably. Unless the recipe calls for triple sec, in which case use whatever you have. The last thing I'm going to say is that in a perfect world, Curaçao would have the global clout to dictate that only Curaçao that comes from Curaçao can be called Curaçao, in the same way that cognac and champagne can only come from their respective regions in France. But sadly, that's not the world we live in. The best any of us can do is support brands with historical provenance, like this one. Yeah, this is great. I don't know about you, but when I think of Curaçao, I think of the Mai Tai. Everyone has heard of the Mai Tai, so I'm not going to go too deep into its history, but for the uninitiated, the drink was invented in 1944 by Vic Bergeron, the genius behind Trader Vic's. Although it may have been inspired by the QB Cooler, which was invented by Don Beach, the genius behind Don the Beachcombers. The story is Trader Vic had a QB Cooler, and the Mai Tai is his attempt to replicate the flavor profile, since Don Beach, and Trader Vic for that matter, kept its recipes secret. Now, if you order a Mai Tai at 100 bars, you'll get a different drink at every one. There are a million ways to interpret this drink, and as many ways to mess it up. Also, very quickly, 5 minutes of internet research will tell you that pineapple and grenadine don't go in a Mai Tai. So, just don't. The drink is actually pretty simple. Orange Curaçao, orgeat, rock candy syrup, lime juice, and rum. Orgeat is syrup made from almonds. There are plenty of good ones out there, but only buy one if you can pronounce all the ingredients. Rock candy syrup is kind of a long story, but a good substitute is 2-to-1 simple syrup. You can use 1-to-1, but the drink will be inferior. Trust me on this. But the biggest challenge to making a killer Mai Tai is what rum to use. It was originally conceived using J-Ray 17, but the drink was so popular that Trader Vic exhausted the world's supply a long time ago. How you approximate the flavor of this extinct rum will have the biggest impact on how good your drink is. This may shock you. I've never had J-Ray 17, but this is the perfect time to stand on the shoulders of giants. In this case, the one and only Jeff Barry, who kickstarted the modern tiki revival with a string of great books. His books aren't the only ones worth reading. I love you. But they're a great place to start. He's a hell of a nice guy, too. Now back to the drink. To approximate the flavor of J-Ray 17, Beach Bum Berry recommends a split base of a dark Jamaican and an aged rum agricole. If you don't know any of those words, he means a Jamaican rum that's dark in color, like Myers, which you've probably seen, and an aged rum from Martinique, also called rum agricole. Rum agricole is a whole other topic. All I'm gonna say is, thanks to loose labeling laws here in the States, the term agricole gets thrown around quite a bit. For this drink, you want a proper rum agricole, and those are made with cane juice rather than molasses, and they're only made in Martinique. I've played around with this combination using a lot of different brands, and most are quite satisfactory, but today I'm trying a new one. For agricole, I'm using Clément's Select Barrel. This stuff is spectacular on its own, but this is the first time I'll be mixing it. Personally, I think Myers is okay, but I think this drink deserves better. Besides, the term dark Jamaican is a little vague. Thankfully, I have something I think will be perfect here. My good friend Stolen Overproof. Here's how I make the drink. Start with 1 ounce each of your Jamaican and your aged agricole. Add 3/4 of an ounce of lime juice, 1/2 orange curacao, and 1/4 each of orgeat and 2-to-1 simple. Shake with plenty of ice and dump into a rocks glass. Sink your spent lime half into the drink and garnish with a few sprigs of mint. And if you're feeling really fancy, hit that mint with some bitters. Cheers. And that, my friends, is the real deal. Very slight orange bite, just a hint of almond. All agricoles have a flavor component that is most commonly referred to as grassy or vegetal. That's definitely here, but the sharp funk of the Stolen Overproof is balancing it out perfectly. This is wonderful. The real tragedy of this drink, though, is that Audrey's hanging out with a friend, and she can't taste this. Eh. If you're intimidated by all the ingredients in this drink, I get it, but you don't have to buy them all at once. Get one a week or one every other week, and before you know it, you'll be there. And if there were ever a drink worth fussing over the details, this is it, believe me. If you liked it, hit like, consider subscribing if you haven't already, and if there's something you think I should try, let me know in the comments. Stay safe, follow the advice of professionals, and now to make another Mai Tai.